Finger, Your Excellency the People's Deputy President, Right Honourable Martha Karua, Your Excellency the People's Prime Minister Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka, colleague, party leaders who are here, and we want to recognize in a special way the party leader of Roots Party, my good friend Wajakoya. We want to recognize the Secretary General of the Jubilee Party, my brother Jeremiah Kioni. We want to recognize the Deputy Party Leader, ODM, my brother Wycliffe Ambetsa Oparanya. We want to recognize the leadership of both Houses of Parliament, and I can see the Honorable Opiyo Wandayi is here, the Minority Leader. The Honorable Ladema Olekina, my brother from the Senate. And we have the Honorable Senator Stewart Majayo. We also do have in the House the Secretary General of ODM, the Senator for Nairobi, the Honorable Sifuna. Honorable Senators present, Honorable Members of the National Assembly present, Honorable Members of the County Assemblies across our country, and we do have the Speaker, Honorable Ken Gondi. Ken Gondi is in the House. Thank you very much. We want to recognize all our visitors and friends who are here today to witness a very momentous day in our history as a democracy. Ladies and gentlemen, as you are aware, on 22nd of February, 14 days ago, we did issue an ultimatum to the KK regime. And that ultimatum expired last night, exactly at midnight. Today, the whole country is on tenterhooks. Kenyans are waiting to know what happens thereafter. That deadline lapsed, and today we have a formal statement from the leadership of Azimio that is going to be presented to the country as a way forward after the Kenya Kwanza regime failed to respond to our ultimatum that required lowering of the high cost of living. That has not been done in the last 14 days. We had the issue of the unilateral recruitment of IEBC. In spite of a protestation, William Ruto and his team has gone ahead to appoint the panel to advertise for recruitment of the IEBC unilaterally and against our protestations. They have also refused to respond to our demand for opening of the servers and an independent audit to be done for Kenyans to know the truth. So today we will be welcoming our leaders here to speak on all the issues that we had raised and to tell Kenyans what happens after midnight, after expiry of our ultimatum. Allow me now to invite to the stage the Honorable Martha Karua to open up the statement.
Nikonja tasiezi karanga uwe hai shagala bagala niko tayari kulipa gharama sitasimama maovu ya kitawala
sitasimama maovu ya kitawala. Statement on the launch of Movement for Defense of Democracy, MDD, against the illegitimate Ruto regime. The election of 2022 handed our country an illegitimate regime that is heartless, reckless, and dictatorial. Kenya Kwanza regime is dangerous for our democracy. And therefore, to restore the dignity of the Kenyan people and to put back our country on the path to prosperity, this illegitimate regime must go. Immediately, the Kenya Kwanza regime illegally forced itself upon the people of Kenya, it embarked on measures whose effect has been to make the cost of basic commodities and services unaffordable to a great segment of our population. This illegitimate regime heartlessly removed subsidies to food, unga, electricity, petrol, diesel and paraffin, thereby increasing the bus fares, removed subsidies to school fees, and has made life unbearable to a majority of Kenyans. Ruto has instead launched a massive propaganda campaign against the subsidies program that was meant to secure the lives of millions of Kenyans from the harsh economic realities. This is happening at a time when virtually every nation on earth has unveiled interventions to shield their citizens from the vagaries of economic decline. Fellow Kenyans, 2 weeks ago, on the 22nd day of February this year, we gathered at the Jibanji Gardens and gave the illegitimate Kenya Kwanza regime a 14-day ultimatum to remove all these cruel policies and failure to which Kenyans would take transformative actions. At that meeting, we said that all subsidies to basic commodities must be restored and taxes must come down within 14 days. We said the process of disbanding and remaking the IEBC must stop completely because it was an exercise in futility, which is null and void, and which is designed to create a William Ruto Commission. We said the IEBC servers must be opened and audited within 14 days. We said that if these demands are not met, we would lead Kenyans to launch a movement for the defense of our democracy in a campaign of mass action and civil disobedience, whose aim is to restore people's power, choices, and sovereignty in terms of who governs them and how. Those 14 days elapsed at midnight, with Kenya Kwanza having done absolutely nothing.
Thank you very much, the Honorable Martha Karua. I would like to now invite to the stage the Honorable Dr. Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka.
Thank you, Buffalo Soldier. Good. Our promise to Ruto and his illegitimate Kenya Kwanza regime. We unleash the people's power for action and launch the movement for defense of democracy. Article 37 of our Constitution provides that, and I quote, every person has the right peaceably and unarmed to assemble, to demonstrate, to picket, and to present petitions to public authorities. End of quote. Article 1 of our Constitution equally provides that, and I quote, all sovereign power belongs to the people of Kenya and shall be exercised only in accordance with this Constitution. The people may exercise their sovereign power either directly or through their democratically elected representatives. End of quote. We are today invoking these provisions of our Constitution 2010 to launch a massive, peaceful, and I repeat, peaceful movement of defiance against an illegitimate, reckless, heartless, incompetent Kenya Kwanza regime. We launch the MDD because Kenya Kwanza is illegitimate and therefore incapable of listening to the cries of our people. The people are now taking back all their delegated powers. It is now action time. Having consulted the public widely and extensively, today we give the much-awaited directions, subject to the constitutional provisions that give the people the power and the right to peaceably and an unarmed assemble, demonstrate and picket. We are calling upon our supporters to action.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think as we speak, the entire nation has been waiting to hear from our leader, the people's president, a man who has fought for our democracy, the champion of devolution, and a man who in the 90s was detained fighting for a multi-party democracy. A man who, while fighting for the second liberation of this country, his opponent, who was declared president by Chebukati illegitimately, was fighting to sustain the YK92 movement. You do recall, ladies and gentlemen, YK had young Kenyans who fought for high deals, higher deals. On the other side, Raila Amolo Odinga led the liberation movement that fought for higher ideals of multi-party democracy, of devolution, and the fruits of freedom we enjoy today. At this hour of utmost peril, it is my pleasure to invite this great Democrat, our leader, the People's President, to speak to the nation. Your Excellency, please.
Get up, stand up. Stand up for your right. Get up, stand up.
Fellow Kenyans, starting today and now, hereby declare the official start of a countrywide mass action for the following reasons. Number one, the high cost of living in Kenya, which is as a result of massive looting of the public resources and heartless withdrawal of subsidies to food, fuel, and education by the Kenya Kwanza regime in the middle of a drought and economic meltdown. To lower the cost of living and to restore the dignity of our people, Mr. Ruto must go. Number two, the overtaxation by this illegitimate regime is killing our businesses, impoverishing families, and damaging opportunities for investments. This must immediately stop for Kenya to economically recover. For this reason, Mr. Ruto must go. Three, the importation of genetically modified organisms, GMOs, by Ruto and company is a scheme to destroy the country's food basket and to make Kenyan slaves to the American multinationals while enriching his cronies. For this reason, Ruto must go.
Ruto must go.
Four, the attempt by Kenya Kwanza regime to single-handedly reconstitute the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission by forming a William Ruto Electoral Commission is a reckless misadventure that is intended to wreck this country. The IBC selection panel is a puppet of Ruto, of Mr. Ruto clique, that intends to create seven Chebukatis who will aid him in stealing the 2027 general elections. For this reason, Ruto must go.
Ruto must go. Ruto must go. Ruto must go. Ruto must go.
Six. The victimization of commissioners Masit, Chiraira, Nyang'aya, and Wanderi for standing with the truth against Chebukati and his cabal in an electoral theft and their removal from office through a kangaroo tribunal was actually meant to create a William Ruto IBC. For this reason, Ruto must go. Seven, the contempt with which the Supreme Court treated the Azimio One Kenya presidential petition is the epitome of judicial thuggery. From the judge's subservient and unprofessional, physically biased remarks and the recent public dalliance with Ruto, the Supreme Court judges confirm Ruto's complete judicial capture. For this reason, Ruto must go.
Ruto must go. Ruto must go. Ruto must go. Ruto must go. Ruto must go. Ruto must go.
Eight. The accumulation of all powers, legislative, executive, and judiciary by Ruto, the perfect definition of tyranny and dictatorship. Ruto is buying the legislature, influencing the Supreme Court, and the sole executive decision maker. This is a dangerous dictator that must not be allowed even a single extra minute in public office. For this reason, Ruto must go. Nine. In the history of Kenya, it is the first time our country is facing a two-tribe regime. An exclusive one-tribe regime in Rwanda resorted to genocide. In 2007-08, the security forces were unable to control the violence in the Rift Valley simply because of a one-sided security force. Kenya Kwanza is a one-sided, illegitimate regime that is planting seeds of ethnic hegemony for a future genocide in Kenya. Only two communities are getting appointed to public service. For this reason, Ruto must go. 10, the creation of unnecessary and unconstitutional offices in the public service, including those of their spouses, daughters, and sons, at the expense of an already overburdened public and an empty exchequer. It's a cruel ploy by Ruto to reward his cronies as he continues to loot the public resources through proxies. For this reason, Ruto must go. Kenya has experienced unparalleled religious harmony, which is the envy of the world. The attempt by Ruto to divide this country along religious and sectarian lines must stop. For this reason, Ruto must go. The tribalization and ethnicization of our civil service by this illegitimate regime through targeted sacking and firing of legitimate public appointments is a career killer and a recipe for future genocide. For this reason, even though the case was stopped, the murder of the ICC witnesses did not and cannot relieve anyone of responsibility for crimes against humanity. We know only too well what Ruto is capable of doing. Kenyans will never forget the painful murder of Yebei, Gicheru, and the burning of innocent children and women in a church in Kiambaa. Neither will we forget the deaths of Msando, Jacob Juma, Kenei, and others. For this reason, the grabbing of public land in Ruai, section of Ngong Forest, part of Eldoret Municipality, part of Langata Primary, Mr. Muteshi's farm, and many other public utilities can no longer be tolerated by Kenyans. And for this reason,
Ruto must go! Ruto must go! Ruto must go!
15, according to the public records, Mr. Gachagua, who was the district officer one in Laikipia, was summarily dismissed from office on the 30th of July, 1997 for gross misconduct, desertion of duty, and reported mismanagement of relief food for Laikipia district. This is a clear show of unsuitability and incompetency. No wonder Gachagua has impudently alluded that Kenya is a company with shareholders whose resources are distributed discriminately on the basis of shares. Today, we begin telling Ruto and Gachagua that we indeed are the true shareholders in this country. All the people of Kenya are collectively shareholders in our country. We begin telling Ruto and Gachagua that we understand that a caring government cannot emerge from an illegitimate regime like Kenya Kwanza. Begin telling Ruto and Gachagua that we have no more patience with an illegitimate regime that is too mean-spirited and too incompetent to deploy resources for an all-out war on poverty and suffering of our people. We have no more patience for an illegitimate regime of hypocrites and fake humanitarianism. We begin telling Ruto and Gachagua that we can't keep living on false promises. We begin telling Ruto and Gachagua our clear understanding that when we keep taking painkillers long enough, they will cease killing the pain. And that is when the real pain will begin. Kenya is ripe for a people's movement for the defense of democracy. And the process begins today, here and now. Yeah. Ruto must go. We launch a campaign of defiance of peaceful picketing, peaceful protests, boycotts, strikes, disobedience, peaceful petitions, peaceful sit-ins, and peaceful demonstrations, and it begins today and now. We also urge the victims of retrogressive policies of this illegitimate regime, including workers, doctors, teachers, nurses, lecturers, students, and the business community, to join this political revolution and movement for change. We are stronger together. As your leaders, we commit to fight, resist, and defy this illegitimate regime side by side with you until our voices are heard and respected. We recognize that only through hardship and sacrifice can our cries be heard and acted on. We will be with you to the bitter end. It is action time. Let us all come out, wherever we are, to make our voices heard and respected. And after we have done that, we, wherever we are, in every corner of the country, we shall finally converge in Nairobi. Take note that on the 20th of March 2023, you have a date with destiny in Nairobi. I repeat, take note that on 20th March of 2023, we have a date with destiny in Nairobi. On that day, our supporters throughout the country shall stage a massive procession in Nairobi for a legitimate and inclusive government. Save that date. We thank you and let the action begin. The movement for the defense of democracy has now started. Asante. 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 You may be seated. Let's go. Inawezekana. Leo ni leo. Inawezekana. Inawezekana. Nimesema yale kwa kimombo, lakini kwa manufaa ya watu wetu wengine, ningependa kusema machache kwa Kiswahili. Kwanza tumetoa taarifa mrefu juu ya hali ya taifa letu vilivyo siku ya leo. Tumesema kuna huzuni katika taifa letu. Wakenya wengi wanasikia ugumu. Gharama ya maisha imepanda. Wiki mbili iliyopita sisi tulitoa taarifa tukampatia Bwana Ruto na serikali yake ilani ya kwamba tungependa kuona baada ya siku 14 gharama ya maisha ikiteremka chini, bei ya bidhaa muhimu ikiteremka chini. Tukasema vile vile tumemwambia jamaa asimamishe kuteuliwa kwa wanachama wa tume ya uchaguzi kabla watu wajashauriana. Tatu tukasema tungependa ile nyungu pale ambayo matokeo ya kura ilipelekwa ifunguliwe ili fanyiwe ukaguzi ukweli ijulikane. Wiki mbili imepita na jamaa hawajafanya chochote, wamekita na wamekaa ngumu, wamekafanya chochote. Kwa hivyo tumesema wakati sasa imepita. Kwa hivyo tumesema kuanzia siku ya leo tunaanza sasa kipindi kipya ya ukombozi. Tunaanza ile chama chetu ya kupinga serikali. Wanaweza kufanya maandamano, wanaweza kufanya mgomo, wanaweza vile vile kukaa pamoja na vile vile kupeleka kumbukumbu kwa shirika lolote. Hayo yote yanakubaliwa na sheria yetu. Katiba letu vile vile nasema ati uwezo katika Jamhuri ya Kenya iko mikononi ya wananchi wa Kenya. Wananchi wanaweza kutumia hiyo uwezo wao wenyewe, au wanaweza kutumia hiyo kupitia kwa viongozi ambao wao wenyewe wamechagua. Sasa kwa sababu Bwana Ruto amejaribu kununua viongozi wengine na vile vile amejaribu kununua mahakama, sasa ni saa ya Wakenya kutumia hiyo uwezo na nguvu kupitia hiyo fungu ya katiba yao mikononi mwao ili waweze kuleta mabadiliko. Na tumesema hiyo ndio sisi tutafuata. Wakenya kuanzia leo watagoma, watafanya maandamano, wataungana pamoja kwa njia ya kuleta mabadiliko katika taifa letu. Na haya yote yatakuwa ni njia ya halali. Watu wataweza kugoma na kufanya maandamano. Wengine wanaweza kwenda kwa vituo vya serikali, wanaweza kwenda hata kwa zile manyumba ya serikali. Ni nyumba ya taifa ya wananchi. Wanaweza vile vile kuungana pamoja na kukaa pamoja na kugoma. Wanaweza kugoma wasiende kwa kazi bila wanavyotaka. Wanaweza kufanya maandamano, wanaweza kufanya maandamano kokote pale wao wako. Kazi ya serikali na ya polisi ni kulinda wananchi. Wakifanya hayo, mradi tu polisi wajue ya kwamba wananchi watafanya maandamano, kazi yao ni kulinda wananchi, sio kunyanyasa wananchi. Na sisi vile vile tumesema hatuna uoga wowote, hatuwezi kutishwa na mtu yeyote. Tutalinda sheria na katiba ya taifa letu dhidi ya wale ambaye walikuwa wamewekwa pale kwa njia ya kibandia. Tuna hakika ya kwamba Ruto na wenzake hawakushinda uchaguzi katika taifa letu. Sisi kama wanaazimio tunajua matokeo ya uchaguzi. Sasa kwa sababu jamaa wamekataa ukaguzi wa nyungu ili pale matokeo yalipelekwa, wa Kenya wana uwezo, na sasa watatumia hiyo uwezo kufanya yale ambayo wanataka. Kwa hivyo tunasema kazi imeanza leo. Wa Kenya sasa wako tayari na wamepewa fursa ya kufanya yale yote ambayo nimesimetaja. Alafu mwisho tumesema ati tuko na dira na tarehe 20 ya mwezi huu wa Machi. Tarehe 20 ya mwezi huu wa Machi, wa Kenya ambao wanafuata azimio na hii chama ya kulinda demokrasia katika taifa letu watakuja Nairobi. ni siku ya Nairobi. Utakuja Nairobi na kutakuwa na maandamano makubwa hapa katika taifa la Shimuja Nairobi kutaka serikali ambayo itaweza kulinda haki yao na sheria zao na kuhakikisha kwamba Wakenya wote wanapata yale ambayo wanataka, kuhakikisha kwamba gharama ya maisha itarudi chini, Wakenya ambao ni wagonjwa wataweza kupata matibabu kwa njia sawa sawa. Vile vile wale watoto wetu ambao wanataka kusoma watapata fursa ya kusoma vile tuliwaahidia. Nimesema vile vile wale ambao wanatafuta kazi watapata kazi. Wale wa mama ambao ni wajane hawana mabwana na wana watoto watapata msaada. Wale maskini tuliwaahidi ati watapata 6,000, hiyo vile vile itakuweko, tutasaidiwa sisi zote kama wanaazimio, tunasimama imara pamoja. Nimeleta vile vile salamu kwa Wakenya wote kutoka kwa Rais mstaafu Uhuru Kenyatta. Sisi hatutaki kuona kama Wakenya wanateseka, wanashikwa wako chaguliwa kwa njia halali. Sasa kwa hivyo haya yote tumesema, azimio yuko mbele. Sasa movement for defense of democracy inaanza kufanya kazi kwa siku ya leo. Asanteni sana. Leo ni leo.
Asante niombe. Sasa turuhusu vina